Lie detection takes a high-tech twist.
There are markers in the eyes that are able to accurately determine if an individual is being deceptive.
The new test claiming to see the truth, how it works, and why the creator calls it better than old school polygraph.
This is San Antonio's Fox News at 9.
Well, they say the eyes are the window to the soul, and one technology company believes they're also the most efficient way to tell if a person is lying. Gabby Hart takes a look at this new technology that claims it knows if you're telling the truth.
A new form of lie detection claims it can see the truth.
There are markers in the eyes that are able to accurately determine if an individual is being deceptive.
Neil Harris is the vice president of Converis, the company that created this new technology called iDetect. It uses only the eyes to determine if a person is lying.
When a human being is being deceptive, that there are these microdilations of the pupils. It's the extra mental energy that it takes to be deceptive.
iDetect has been in the works since 2003. Only taking 30 minutes to complete, this new testing technology could be faster and more efficient than the old school polygraph. Its creators argue that iDetect may have the edge because it isn't influenced by any human bias.
So by removing the human element, we believe we can make the assessment of credibility far more forensic in nature.
Ron Slay is a security consultant who administers polygraph exams. He says in his 40 years of experience, he's seen all forms of deception, and he thinks it takes more than a computer system and answering a few questions to detect a lie.
You can't automate the human mind.
We wanted to put both methods to the test, so I sat down to see which machine would best read my lie.
I'm in the hot seat.
First, we put the standard polygraph to the test. Slay asked me two questions that were simple enough to answer honestly.
Now, I want everybody to watch the blue line. Is today Tuesday?
Yes.
But before he even finished asking me the third question...
At work, did you ever look at a boss with sincere eyes when you knew the reaction is already over? It took off and it's barely coming back again.
Then we tested iDetect. Harris had me write down a number between 2 and 8 and then hide it. I chose the number 7. The examiner told me to lie about my number to the machine, but to tell the truth on all the other questions as the iDetect system calibrated my eyes and then monitored my pupil dilation.
I did not choose the number 7. 8 was not the number that I picked.
Look at the spike on the 7.
Safe to say that I got caught lying or preparing to lie on both tests. But Slay says it can sometimes be harder to catch the people you want to catch because they have their own truths.
They're not really answering your questions at all. They are answering what they perceive to be your questions.
Slay and Harris agree that both iDetect and polygraphs can get it wrong sometimes.
There will be some false positives and false negatives with iDetect as it exists today.
But Harris says the beauty of computer algorithms is that they get smarter over time.
I trust computers and algorithms far more than I would another human being.
Still, the polygraph remains a powerful detection tool, not likely to be replaced anytime soon.
I think it's the age-old argument of man against the machine.
Big-time technology company Apple has taken notice of iDetect. Apple purchased the sensor technology that's used to calibrate and read the eyes. Does this mean our iPhones could eventually become handheld lie detectors? Harris says, only time will tell. I'm Gabby Hart reporting.